Yo, what's going on, everybody? It's IpodKingCarter here, the Superman of YouTube. It's about that time, you guys. It's February. It's finally time for 2K Sports to start thinking about ideas to build the new game, NBA 2K14. And today, I'm trying to drop a little bit of knowledge. I'm trying to drop a little bit of thoughts, ideas. This is my wish list. This is my fans' wish list, my subscribers' wish list, my wish list, my mom's wish list. Nah, I'm playing. But let's jump into the video. I don't want to waste no time. First thing I want to say to you guys is, if you don't have the time to watch this video, I don't know how long it's going to be, but if you don't have time to watch it, what I want you to do is go inside the description, right? It's going to be timestamps on certain topics that I talk about, such as my player, my career, association, online. It's going to be timestamps there. What's going to be the timestamp is when I start that topic. So if you want to skip to a certain topic that you want to hear about or that you have thoughts on that you want to leave in the comment section, go ahead, jump to those topics, leave your thoughts in the comment section. The only way that they will develop a good game is if you guys let your voice be heard. So let's start off the home screen. Yeah, that's my first topic. I'm starting from scratch. The home screen, I love it, but I hate it. I want it to be set more like basketball. Like, take NBA.com, for instance, or take TNT, ESPN, things of that nature, certain websites. How about you guys set up the home screen something like that? More NBA feel than just, you know, a game. Secondly, I want to jump right into my player. The first thing is, they need to upgrade the creation slots to 5 at one time or under only one user. Now, what I mean by is, say you want to create a point guard, you want to create a shooting guard, you want to create a small forward. There shouldn't be a problem with you creating a player to play online or offline as many slots as you want. They only give you one guy, one slot, and if you want to create a new player, you either got to make a new account, or if you create that player on that current account, it may mess up your whole entire my player scene, and you might not even be able to play blacktop. It's that simple. Now, moving on. Some accessories do not have the option to be color coordinated. I don't know if that was a problem in the game with NBA 2K13, but if I wanted to wear double rubber bands, I couldn't change them to the color of Team Color 2 or something like that. Also, some accessories couldn't even be bought. If we purchase gear to upgrade our attributes, there needs to be a sign of some sort to show that they're working. Like, take if I brought compression shorts. It shows, okay, +2 before the game start, compression shorts, whatever that attribute bump gives you. I need to be able to see that all game long, such as with the signature skills. If you guys have signature skills, you have to have gear that show what attributes get bumped all game long. All right, next up. Blacktop clothing and gear are fine. No problem. I see that you guys are making new updates. You just dropped the Hardwood Classics update. I kind of like that, but there needs to be some sort of purchase history for items that you already purchased in store. So such as, I brought a Philadelphia t-shirt. Okay, it disappeared. That means that it's purchased. No, I want to see something on a side panel where as though it says purchased and not purchased. I would love to see that. It would make things a whole lot easier for when you're buying stuff and when you guys add more and more to the table. Next thing. When equipping your player with jewels and sneakers, they should work in every mode and not be reset because you played a mode that didn't need your my player in it. Such as, if I played a quick game and then I went to the blacktop, my jewels would be gone. If I played a quick game and I went into my career and I went to the press conference, my jewels would be gone. It's that simple. Next up, in creation, we need more hairstyles. I don't know how many times that we're going to say this, but we want more hairstyles. When you guys see certain players out there in a league with these hairstyles and you give those hairstyles to those guys, it should be no problem why you can't put that hairstyle into the package or the rotation of creations. Next up, we need more tattoos. One thing is, try and make packages from actual players' sleeves and designs. Such as, say somebody wanted all of LeBron's tattoos. It shouldn't be a problem where you put LeBron James' tattoo package inside of the tattoos to choose from. It's that simple. You don't have to choose elbow, sidearm, shoulder, neck, all of that. You can just say straight up full body LeBron James. And then you'll have his whole tattoo set up. Next thing, we need more endorsed gear. Take Nike, for instance. Okay, we have a couple Nike things, Adidas things, such as that. But how about you guys give us like finger bands and, you know, like double rubber bands for like Live Strong or, you know, some type of feel for it. You know, that I would love to see that. Next up, we need to have more voices to choose from for press conferences, GM meetings, and pregame shows. Now, you guys already know what I'm talking about. When you hear your my player and you look at your my player, does your my player sound how he should look? That's what I mean. There should be no problem for 2K to put in, let's say, 3 to 5 voice packages. Keep the current package they have. You can give it a down south accent. You can give it a East Coast, Upper East Coast, New York, Philadelphia type accent. You know, more broad, more hood. Not like no a none of that, but you know, more deep. You know, the voices sometimes, man, it just throws me off because you'll listen to your my player be so cocky, but it just doesn't sound right. But next up, I know it's a long shot, but have y'all heard of something called Game Face? I'm not talking about Game Face Studios. I'm talking about Game Face from EA. How about you incorporate some type of fact where people can actually take a picture of themselves and make their own cyber face? That would be awesome. Next up is My Career. Yeah, I'm moving right along. First off, the VC idea is golden, but people should never get kicked to SP ever. If they are offline, let it sync to your servers when they get back online. Don't just bump them down to SP. Next up, purchasing everything is more realistic. I get that. But can we get those player dunk packages back, such as LeBron James and things like that and all of that? Also, keeping the individual ones and 6 skills are great, but it limits the player it should fit, such as if I'm a 6'7 point guard, I should be able to get brick wall and eraser because I'm that tall, not because of the position that you have. It should be height and weight. You know, like say somebody wants chase down artists, they have to be what, 6'6 and up and athletic. You know, that's just the way I look at it. Also, the social Twitter idea was perfect, but can we turn it into a feature, into like a mailing system? Let's say like having a little iPhone in the bottom right corner that you can click on to actually read messages. Next up, NBA.com is great, but can we have news that's more relevant, such as injuries, instead of just signings and power rankings? Okay, I know LeBron and them won last night, but LeBron and them game may not have been the highlight of the night. You know, maybe I wanted to see a little bit more in the NBA.com than just people saying, oh, we're signing a new player or somebody's on a trade rumor mill or something like that. You know, next. The key game systems suck. This is why. I know for a fact that, you know, you guys try to match us up with star matchups and rival games. But how about you let us choose who we play on a calendar all season long? If I want to skip 20 games, I should have the right to sim until that day. Which means, if I don't want to play the first week of my NBA career, I don't want to play the first week. If I want to skip 3 weeks, let me skip 3 weeks. Don't just key game me up against Kobe, Durant, LeBron. I don't want that in my life. Now, off court. This is strictly off court. There should be actual clips of when you do NBA Cares campaigns, such as short commercials. You know, when you did the shoe commercial, that was in the game last year. Why not do some NBA Cares or something like that? Also, if you take your fellas out to a team dinner, why not have you guys walking into a nice restaurant, sitting down and laughing and giggling? That shouldn't be hard to make, right? Also, it's your career. So where's your agent? I believe that a player should have an agent, right? Now, next thing, and in the offseason, can we please get a workout camp? Can we go to the Olympics? Can it be draft combines? Can it be summer circuits? Can it actually be something like real basketball instead of a rookie showcase? I don't know. Just my thoughts. Next, on court. There needs to be more emotion and interaction between players all game long. If I hit a three-pointer, I need to be able to high-five a guy on the way down the court. The coach and players, for instance, should lock eyes and talk when a player is adjusting to calling plays, like real basketball. And please, bring back the huddles during timeouts. When I take a timeout, it shouldn't be a quick beep and then the game starts. What if I need 60 seconds to, you know, think of a play that may work? Also, the Gatorade dunk should be automatic when a team wins, especially when they're at home. Next up, press conferences, there needs to be more questions, more interactions, and more than just one question and one voiceover. Say, for instance, if I'm in Portland and I go to Miami, why don't you guys give me a reporter that sounds like he's from Miami? Ronnie2K, I know you do. I know that you do the voiceovers for the questions, but please, give me somebody else, man. I love you to death, but give me somebody else. Next, I know a lot of people wanted to hear about this. Gameplay for my career. Now, passing is still broken. And bounce passing, we're not even going to talk about it. Three-pointers from wherever or whoever are too high of an success rate. Dunking is out of this world. It's that simple. Once an animation is started, there's no stopping that person. Stealing on ball needs to be turned up for people who have pickpocket and a 99 steal rating, or let's say a 85 and higher rating. It should make it a little bit easier instead of guys getting reaching calls all game long. I know you tried to tune it because guys was hating on it, but if you got pickpocket and you spent your money on and that VC on it, then you should be able to steal. Speed is okay. Dribbling is amazing, of course, you can tell from my videos, but awareness and double teams need to be fixed immediately. It's no reason why a guy should be able to run out of a double team and dunk on every play. Alley-oops are okay in my career, but momentum shots have to be stopped just by a simple tuning. Now, next up, I'm moving straight along, we're going into my team. Me, I know nothing of my team except better packs and more VC per game, and make that VC separate from any other mode. No cheating to get your my players up. It's that simple. And sorry to say, but learn a few new tricks from EA's Ultimate Team. Now, what I mean by that is have better cards to purchase, such as say somebody wants MJ. Why don't you be able to give them a 96 MJ? Or a 98 MJ. That's all I'm saying about that. Next up, I'm moving straight along, guys. Now, let's talk about game modes. Association and the online version need to be in the same tab. I haven't heard many complaints about that mode, but if you can share your thoughts in the comment section, I will highly appreciate it, and I will highlight those comments and put them inside the description as well. Now, season is okay. As it is for playoffs, it needs to be upgraded to matchups from every team of all time. That would be hot. That means that if you want to actually see the 2001 Sixers against Lakers, that would be dope. That's all I'm saying. You know, practice on a blacktop would be a good addition to practice mode. I know there's a lot of different modes and training camps and all of that, but practicing on a blacktop would help as well. Create a legend is fine to me, but any player that's on NBA 2K14 needs to be available, and no need to have a challenge to unlock those people. Just give us everybody. If we have to pre-order some DLC to get a special team, have those special players available for Create a Legend. It's that simple. Now, blacktop offline, it needs 1v1 to 5v5, which means if you want to go one-on-one with somebody in a blacktop and 2-on-2, 3-on-3, 4-on-4, 5-on-5, with calls and things like that, that should be available. You know, it shouldn't be that hard to do that. Now, online, this is where it's getting tricky. Online, the record-keeping system sucks. When I play and I win, y'all guys tally it as a loss. So why should I play ranked games? Give the fans a reason to play. Quick rank games have so many little glitches that a lot of people tolerate it, but you guys try to patch it when you can. But I say, for instance, quick match is definitely something that you want to fix online. A lot of guys love playing ranked matches, and that's something that you guys should focus on as online, because that right there is you guys' core. Everybody loves to go head to head. It's that simple. Next up, let's talk about the team up. If you guys know what team up is, it's when you guys get about 10 players and you play as real NBA players on the team. That needs to be better with matchmaking. Now, let's change a little things, such as location. Let's say a person wants to play some guys from Japan. Why can't they change their time zone to Japan so they can actually get matched up with a couple guys from those servers? I don't know. It's kind of tricky. I can't get into all that. I'm not a developer, you know, so if you guys can make that easier where you can have private lobbies from my team and, you know, you just pick guys that's actually online from a different country that you don't know, that would be awesome. Next thing, blacktop. Yeah, I'm ready to talk about the blacktop. The shoes that I pick in the My Player tab should work on my feet, not the ones that I pick in my career. Somehow, someway, that ended up breaking somewhere along the lines for NBA 2K13, so please fix that for 2K14. Now, even if I created them in the shoe creator or something like that, they should work on my feet online because that is a part of you guys' game. Nike ID shoe creator, it shouldn't be that hard. Now, you should be able to send an invite to anyone, even if they're not on your friends list. This is easy for Xbox, but for PS3, it's the hardest thing in the world. You don't have it on invite only. You don't have it on joinable. You can only play with people that are on your friends list, which makes it kind of hard because you can only have 100 friends. And for people like me, 100 ain't enough. Now, if you make a lobby invite only, you should be the only person who can invite people to that lobby and put the option on to kick players as well. It's been plenty of times I've live streamed, added a couple guys, and I want 6 players, but I get 10. It shouldn't be no reason that should happen. If I am the host, the leader, it's no reason for me to do that. Now, moving into gameplay. Blacktop is fun. It's serious at sometimes, but it's definitely fun. There should not be a time clock on 3v3. Dunking needs to be able to be blocked. Spamming for steals needs to be passed. How about calling calls for possessions? Not points, just possessions. Momentum shots can't be stopped. They even looked glitched sometimes. Stamina should be a big factor. If a player is on turbo all game long to 21, he should get tired eventually. And let's talk about score limits. How about bumping up the game to 45 points? Or how about a 5v5 on a blacktop with calls and shot clock plus more fans? But I love their announcer, you know, when he says cookies and that's cash. But moving in, the big addition. This is something that everybody wants, including myself. Let's talk about crew mode. Now, it's time for crew mode to make its return. It has been 2 years going on 3 now without crew mode. I think 2K has had more than enough time to add it back to the game. I'm not worried about sales, just gaming with my friends. As an addition to that, can we build our own arenas? Can we build our own jerseys from scratch with new emblems or even emblems that we make? Can we make our own shoes? Can we actually have our own accessories that we make with our own logos? Can we choose a city? Can we choose a new head coach and mascot? Can we please have crew mode back? That's all I ask. Now, moving on. Features. 2K Share is broken. It is a big freezing issue when certain people are downloading certain player DNAs. I don't know why it's messed up, but hopefully it's fixed for NBA 2K14. 2K shoes, we need to be able to equip those shoes or add those shoes to any player on any team at any time. It's no reason why we should only be able to add certain shoes to generic players and can't add them to, say, Kobe. Say we want Kobe to wear our sneaker. You know, add that feature to the game. Also, if we create it, we need to be able to use it. Which means, if you guys have codes or you don't want to tell us what type of codes are in the game, how about you make a website where as though people that pre-order the game can get the code and then they'll just give it out to the masses when the game drops. Make it that simple. Now, options. Roster and settings should not be reset for any reason, which means when I'm playing a game, it's no reason that my rosters should reset after I come out of my career. It's no reason why my settings should reset after I come from online. If I play on 2K camera view on quick game match and it's supposed to turn like that into online, it's no reason why the settings should ever be reset. But that's the end of my wish list. I know it was kind of long, and I'm sorry. I know it's taking up a lot of time. But like I said, if you guys have any ideas inside the comment section, please leave them there. What's going to happen is this video is going to go out to 2K Sports. It's going to go to Ronnie2K, LD2K. It's going to go to every single developer that I know at 2K headquarters. Like I said, guys, I've been doing this 2K thing for a long time. I've been doing YouTube for 2 going on 3 years now, and I'm the voice for y'all. If those guys don't want to listen, I'm going to make them listen. I'm going to pound it into their head until they listen. Also, if you're wondering how I did this commentary, I did it all off my iPhone. I've been looking at my iPhone this entire commentary because I was literally at work making a list of things that I want and reading you guys' comments off of my Instagram and adding them into the mix. So like I said, if you have any concerns, questions, ideas, leave them in the comment section. I'm going to be thumbing things up, responding to comments. I'm even going to be jotting down you guys' comments. Please leave them in the comment section. Also, if you skip to the end of this video right here, right now, and you want to know where to go to listen to your certain topic, go inside the description because I've timestamped everything I've said in this entire commentary. But this is IKC signing out, and I will see you guys in my next video. And let's pray and hope for NBA 2K14. And please, please get your Tebow on for crew mode. We need crew mode back. People like me, K Spade, we can't live without crew mode. Blacktop is not enough. You know, me and Spade, we just got done playing Call of Duty. That's how bad we need crew back. If we had crew, it'd be a whole different story. And also, 2K. I know about EA having a little bit of shares into your company, such as, you know, purchasing a little bit of, you know, property, equity, whatever you want to call it. It's no problem for you guys to, you know, not steal a couple ideas, but learn from the best. EA may not have the best graphics, but they have some of the most mind-provoking ideas. But this is IKC signing out, and I'm going to holler at you on the next one. Peace.